Hi to all. In this video, we are going to see about design of the field system of non-salient pole alternator. Okay, in case of turbo alternators, the rotor windings or the field windings are distributed in the rotor slots. The rotor construction of the turbo alternator is shown in the figure. Okay, north, north, south, south. Okay, like that. These are the slots. And field coils, these are the field coils. This will be positive charge and this will be this will be the positive charge and this will be negative charge. Okay, this is the shaft. Okay, normally 70% of the rotor is slotted and remaining portion is unslotted in order to form the pole. Okay, the design of the field can be explained as follow. Selection of rotor slot. Total number of rotor slots may be assumed as 50 to 70% of the stator slots pictures. Okay, however, this so found rotor slots must satisfy the following conditions in order to avoid the undesirable effect of harmonics in the flux density waveforms. Okay, there should be no common factor between the number of rotor slots pictures and number of stator slot pitches. Number of wound rotor slot should be divisible by 4 for a two pole synchronous machine. That means the number of rotor slots must be multiple of 4. Okay. Width of the rotor slot is limited by the stress developed at the rotor teeth and the end rings. Design of rotor winding. Okay. And full load field MMF can be taken as twice the armature MMF. TATFL full load is equal to 2 into ATA, that is 2 into 1.35 into multiplied with I phase T phase KW by P. Standard exciter voltage of 110 to 220 volt may be taken. Okay, with 15 to 20% of this may be reserved for field control. Hence, voltage across each field coil VF is equal to 0.8 to 0.85 voltage per pole. Okay. Length of the mean turn LMT is equal to 2L plus 1.8 tau P plus 0.25 M. Sectional area of each conductor AF is equal to XLMT multiplied with IF multiplied with TF by VF. Assume suitable value of current density in the rotor winding. So 2.5 to 3 amp per millimeter square for conventionally cooled machines and 8 to 12 amp per millimeter square for large and special cooled machines. Okay. Find area of the all rotor conductors per pole is equal to 2 into IF multiplied with TF by del F. Find the number of rotor conductors per pole is equal to 2 into IF field current divided by TF divided by del F AF. Number of field conductors per slot is equal to 2 multiplied with IF into TF divided by del F and AF multiplied with SR, where SR is number of rotor slots. Resistance of each field coil RF is equal to X LMT multiplied with TF by AF. Calculate the current in the field coil IF is equal to VF by RF. Based on the above data, dimensions may be fixed. The ratio of slot depth of slot width may be taken between 4 to 5. Enough insulation has to be provided such that it withstands large amount of mechanical stress and force coming on the rotor. The following insulations may be provided for the field coils. All field conductors are provided with mica tape insulation. Okay, various strands, the slots separated by each other by 0.3 mm mica separators. 0.5 mm odd mica cell is provided on the field coils. Over the above insulation, 1.5 mm flexible micro insulation is provided. Lastly, a steel cell of 0.6 mm is provided on the whole field coil. Example, design the rotor of three ways. Okay, what is the question? Turbo alternator with the following designs. Solution, number of rotor slots, selection of rotor slots, to nothing but total number of rotor slots may be assumed 50 to 70% of stator slots. Normally 70% of the rotor slots is remaining portion is unslotted. So number of stator slots 36. So from this 70%, okay, hence number of rotor slots which is between 18 to 26. Satisfy the conditions, number of rotor slots which is equal to 23. Number of wound slots is equal to 16. Area of field conductor, assume 40 volt in the field regulator. Voltage across field coil is equal to 220 minus 40 by 2. So 90 volts armature voltage, armature ampere turns per volt. ATA is equal to 1.35 I phase T phase KW by phase. So when you substitute the value of 1.35 into 1050 24,380 is a specific electric loading value. Assuming full load field ampere turns per pole is equal to 2 ATA. So 2 into 24 into 3, 24,300 will get 48,680. Mean length of the turn is given by LM. T is equal to L by 1.8 OP plus 0.25. So 2 into L 2.2 plus 1.8 multiplied with tau P value 1.256 plus 0.25. So we will get the value is equal to 7.31 meter. Area of field conductor, AF is equal to X LML multiplied with IF and TF divided by VF. Here VF value we found 90. This one is the VF value. Okay. And TF 48,600 we found, and IF value 7.31 and LMT 0.021. So we will get 83.22 millimeter square. Okay. So field current. So number of field turns, full load ampere turns per pole is equal to 48,600. At full load field, ampere conductors per pole is equal to 2 into 48,080. So assuming the current density of 2.6 ampere per millimeter square, area of rotor conductor is equal to 2 into 80 value, 48,600 divided by 2.6 will get 37,400 millimeter square. Number of rotor conductors per pole is equal to 37,400 divided by 84,445. Number of wound slots per phase pole is equal to 16 by 2 is equal to 8. Number of conductors per slot is equal to 445 by 8. That is value will be 56. Modified value of conductors per pole 56 into 8, 448. Number of field turns per pole TF is equal to 448 by 2, 224. Number of coils per pole 8 by 2 is equal to 4. Field current, resistance of the field coil, RF is equal to X LMT multiplied by TF by AF. So when you substitute the values, we will get 0.41. Current in the field winding, IF is equal to V by I is equal to V by R. So here you see by RF is equal to 90 by 0.41. The current is equal to 219 ampere current. Thank you.